Hello, my name is Sergio Pérez. My pronouns are he, him, his, and I serve as Loras College's diversity officer.
What's your favorite music?
I think it very much depends on the mood of the day. If I'm trying to have a good time on the weekend, you could see me, you know, listening to some pop dance music, whether it's Gaga or Madonna. I'm kind of an old school guy in that sense. Otherwise, if I'm going home to visit a family, you're going to hear me listening to some norteños, to some cumbias, to that regional Mexican music that you'll find on Spotify. But really, it just depends on kind of the cause or the weekend or the mood that I'm going to be a part of.
What is your favorite type of food?
You know, right now, because it's getting colder, I would love a big bowl of pozole or some tamales. It's tamale season for many Latinos. For me, it's tamales rojos de puerco, right? Pork tamales, particularly the ones that my mom makes. You know, outside of that, I have also been known to enjoy a good, delicious hamburger, cheeseburger, a hot dog. But then I also like my sushi. So really, I'm not a discriminator of any kind of food. But, you know, I guess at the end of the day, my favorite food has to be, you know, the food I grew up with, that Mexican food.
What is your favorite holiday?
You know, I like to say Christmas or Thanksgiving because families and friends get together and have big meals, spend time inside. You get to decorate for the seasons or the holidays. And I think that's really cool, especially with social media. You get to see other families and other friends do their thing. And when they post pictures, but I think for me, through the years, my favorite holiday has become Dia de los Muertos. Just that time to you know, reflect and sit back and remember your loved ones is something that I've come to appreciate as I get older.
What is your favorite dream vacation spot?
I love, you know, it's not a dream because I'm able to do this, so I'm happy for that. But I love going to Mexico City. Mexico City is a big city, has amazing food, so much history there, that is a place I'll go to as much as I can. So that's my favorite vacation place.
What do you do in your position at Loras?
Yeah, so I dabble in a little bit of everything, I would say. I think primarily I engage our students, particularly our office in the Center for Inclusion and Advocacy works with our Black, African American, Latinx students who are the first in their family to go to college. So if you're a first gen, I love engaging that community. Students who might identify with from the LGBT community and students who are coming from international homes. So all that coalition, I love engaging with, whether it's having them, you know, build up some support so they can be successful here at Loras, getting to know them and building, bringing some of their culture on our campus so they feel affirmed, but all the way to working with faculty and staff and providing trainings, thoughts on kind of how we could be a better campus that better supports diversity, equity, inclusion, and issues of justice. That is in a very broad descriptor of kind of what I do, but you'll see me in the academics, in the co-curricular, in athletics, trying to build bigger community for all.
How important is inclusion in college?
Inclusion, I think, is a huge piece. I think all of us are coming from different homes, from different life stories, from different journeys, to a place where we expect to become a melting pot. And I think that's one of the myths of the United States is that we just blend in. And I don't think that's the case at all. I think all of us have very unique things that contribute to a tapestry, a rough tapestry that brings people together. So I think inclusion is so important because I want everyone, this college wants everyone to feel like they are part of it too. If it's basketball and you're succeeding in basketball, that's part of the Loras story. If you're the first one in your family to come to college and earn that Loras bachelor's degree, that's also a part of the Loras story. Regardless of who you are, regardless of your circumstances, if you want an education, this is a place that you should be able to get it. And that's why inclusion is such a big thing for colleges and universities.
What do you offer to students around campus?
You know, I think it depends on the students. Some students, I would hope that they're saying that I provide companionship in terms of helping them along their Loras journey. I hope that folks would say that I offer an ear. I know there's moments where I have students that come into my office regularly, and other students that maybe will pop in once a semester. regardless of their story or how frequently they might engage. I hope that they all say that I can offer an ear, but also a willingness to assist them with whatever issue that might come up. And that's the cool piece about my job, that I could help a student one day find textbooks, or I could help the next student find someone in Dubuque that can help them with the car as they, you know, need a mechanic. All the way to immigration issues and visas, all the way to you know, figuring out how to pay for college in this coming semester. So I think that's the kind of the services, if you will, or engagement I can provide our Duhawks.
What do you like most about your job?
I think the ability to be able to connect and meet with all sorts of Duhawks every single year, and be invited to be part of those journeys. I have had the luxury, the joy, the honor of seeing students who come in thinking one way, and who graduate with a greater sense of care and a greater sense of consideration for others. And I think that is such a beautiful thing, to see students grow and learn and become better versions of themselves, right? And I think that's the cool thing about working here at Loras, is that we have students doing that every single day from first year all the way to their senior year. Folks who just bring out the very best values of all of humanity.